fucking loser. You're a bad cop and a fucking thief, and if that's not a rat, I don't know what is.
Can I get a cigarette? I need a cigarette. Thank you.
Do you know Vincent Santini?
Doesn't ring a bell, no.
Remember, Mikey, in this game you score points when you answer the questions.
And I told you that it doesn't ring a bell. It works for your uncle. Does the dirty work, if you know what I mean. And?
He killed one of our agents, per your uncle's request. We want to get even.
So where do I come in?
You're going to help us find him. Like I said before, you help us, we help you.
Help me? You two are going to help me? How are you going to help me rat out my family? What do you two take me for?
Well, let us worry about that.
Can I talk to my lawyer now?
Sure, you can talk to your lawyer all you want. Bottom line is you are up Schitt's Creek without a paddle. If I were you, pal, I would look long and hard at my loyalties and my priorities. This is one time when selfishness is acceptable and recommended. Looking at your choices, you've got no choice.
Time, Vince. You've been well compensated. My question to you is why?
I don't know, Polly. I just can't do it anymore.
What's the matter? Find God?
No.
Oh, you've been reborn or something?
It's not like that.
Oh, what is it?
I don't like myself anymore. I don't like what I do.
This is a business. It's a job. You're paid well to do it, so you do it. You know, nobody ever said you're supposed to like it.
Well, it's taking its toll on me.
Toll? Toll. This is the only life you've ever known, Vince. What would you do? Where would you go?
Someplace quiet, live off my savings.
Oh. Like a retirement? Let me tell you something, this ain't no corporation. This ain't too familiar. This is your family. You just don't walk away and pick up a 401k.
I knew this was going to bother you, but I really thought that you'd be more understanding.
Oh, what's the matter, Vince? Didn't I treat you right?
Oh, come on, it's got nothing to do with that.
It's got everything to do with that. If you got problems, then I got problems.
Are you saying you don't trust me? You think I'm gonna leak?
In this business, Benny, you can't be too careful. You got rid of enough garbage for me to know that.
Yeah. Enough to know that I've earned your trust. But what I'm sensing here is not trust.
Benny, as you're well aware, the only way out of this life is with a bullet in your head.
That's the gratitude I get, huh?
I trust you enough to let you walk, Vince.
But you gotta do me this one last favor.
Then I walk.
Yeah, Vinny, you walk. Into the sunshine, just like John Wayne.
I'm the boss. You do what I say, when I say it, and we'll be fine.
You got that.
If you can trust me. You earn trust. I don't even know you.
You think I'd fuck my uncle over?
Like I said, I don't know you.
Look, I was sent here to help you on this job. And I expect a little courtesy and a little respect.
You can help me by not fucking this thing up. It's all the help I need.
I can tell that this is going to be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Don't get all Humphrey Bogart on me. Let's just do this thing and get it over with.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. better come and shut the fuck up! Give me one fucking reason not to blow your fucking head up, you miserable little prick!
For starters, Paulie will have you skinned alive. That's good enough reason for you.
I'm already fucked with Paulie. I've got nothing to lose.
You're fucked. I'm fucked. I'm the one that shot him. Get off me, man. Get off.
I told you. No killing. We have to take him in alive. Don't fuck this up for me. Did you listen to anything I told you?
The prick was being difficult.
Knock his ass out! You didn't need to shoot him!
So what now?
Now what? What do you mean, now what?
What's the plan?
What's the plan? There is no fucking plan.
Paulie is gonna go apeshit.
Fuck, I'll talk to Paulie. I'll take care of that. Listen to me, you and me have bigger problems right now.
You bet your ass we do.
She got a good look at us, Vince. She got a good look at us. You should have let me take care of her right then and there.
We didn't have time to go chase her down, you asshole. The cops would have been there any second.
Yeah, and they would have found one dead bitch. We had plenty of time. You know what? For a cool hitman, you're pretty soft. Is that why you're quitting the business?
Call me Jill. This is my friend Doreen. Hello.
Hello, Doreen. Miss Grant, I mean Jill. I'd like to thank you very much for your cooperation with this investigation.
I just don't see how I can possibly be of any help to you. I didn't see a thing.
I understand that. And I know you've already gone through this, but is there anything else you can recall? Did you hear anything?
You mean other than the gunshot?
Yes, was anything said?
Like I told Detective Pendergast, the shot was so loud it made my ears ring. All I remember after that is a man's voice screaming at another man, I suppose.
What was he screaming?
Well, I couldn't repeat what he said.
It was pretty nasty.
Oh, you were there?
Oh, no, sir. Jill told me about it.
It was nothing, really. Just a barrage of obscenities.
Well, we're all grown ups here, Jill. I think I can handle it.
You fucking idiot.
Excuse me?
What the fuck's the matter with